Joining Trump as he prepares for the debate today is former New York City Mayor Rudy Giuliani. Mr. Mayor, thanks for coming back once again.
Nice to be here, Jake.
So last time you were on this program, we talked about whether Donald Trump had ever groped women without their consent, the way he described doing so on the Access Hollywood tape. This is a snippet of our conversation there.
Who did he do that to?
Well, first of all, I don't know that he did it to anyone. This is talk.
So that was Sunday morning. Since you and I had that conversation, 9 women have come forward and said effectively, yes, Donald Trump either kissed me or touched me sexually without my consent. Their names are Jessica Leeds and Kristen Anderson,
right,
Temple Taggart McDowell, Mindy McGivelray, Rachel Crooks, Kathy Heller, Natasha Stoyanov, Summer Zervos. Mr. Mayor, do you believe every one of these women is lying?
No, I believe my friend Donald Trump when he tells me he didn't do it. I know Donald. I've been with him for 28 years. I've never seen him do anything like that. I haven't been able to focus on every single one of the things that they've said. The one on the airplane, there is an independent witness who says it's not true. The one involving
that guy who used to procure that former pimp guy that you're talking about?
You don't pick who the witnesses are to watch something. I don't get to select who the witnesses are that are sitting around me. So far, no one's come forward to corroborate what she said. And this man's come forward on his own and said it's not true. Second, one of them, I think it was one of the contestants, was telling her cousin wonderful things about him up until the time he didn't go to her restaurant opening about 3 or 4 months ago. Then she turned on him and became very bitter. And he doesn't believe it's true.
So you think the 9 women are lying? You believe Donald Trump?
I would not say it that way. I believe Donald Trump. I don't know about the 9 women. I haven't studied the case. I'm a lawyer. I'd have to study each case to tell you that. I'm not going to engage in Clinton-type conduct and attack them. I'm just telling you that I believe he's telling the truth. I do not believe some of these things appear to me on their face to be kind of untrue.
Okay.
15 minutes of groping in a first-class cabin of an airplane, it doesn't make sense. I've been in first class a lot, fortunately, since I stopped being mayor. I can afford first class. You see everything that goes on in first class.
So Donald Trump, you just kind of alluded to the fact that Donald Trump has condemned the Clintons for attacking Bill Clinton's accusers, the women who accused Bill Clinton of misconduct. You're kind of refraining from doing so, even though you're questioning some of these accounts. But Donald Trump is out there on stages calling them liars and actually, in some instances, attacking how attractive they are, basically suggesting that they're not attractive enough for him to ever kiss or grope without consent. For those voters out there, Mr. Mayor, who are inclined to believe all of these women, all 9
right.
of Trump's accusers and Bill Clinton's accusers, and just say, you know what, I believe all these women. How are they supposed to reconcile this, given the fact that empirically, Trump is attacking these women much, much more so than the Clintons ever did?
No, that's not true.
The bimbo sure it is.
It is not. The bimbo squad.
Donald Trump's out there giving speeches attacking them, calling them liars, and saying that they're not good-looking enough.
I really don't want to dispute this with you. I mean, the four women who I met with tell me that Hillary Clinton was engaged in all kinds of attacks on them, both public and private. But in any event, shouldn't we be beyond that now? Shouldn't we be beyond Donald Trump's past and Hillary Clinton's past? And shouldn't we be talking about who's going to raise taxes and lower taxes? Who's going to deal with ISIS? Who isn't? Who created ISIS? What are we going to do in Somalia, where obviously we have a ground war going on in Somalia, although the president says no boots on the ground, we have boots on the ground.
Yeah, these are things that Donald Trump is not mentioning in his speeches at all. Donald Trump's speeches, as you know, are basically he goes out there and he attacks the women who are accusing him. And by the way, when you talk about shouldn't we be over this, Donald Trump, the women that you just referred to, the 3 women who accused Bill Clinton of sexual assault or worse, and the woman who Hillary Clinton was a court-appointed attorney to represent her rapist, those 4 women, Donald Trump brought them to the Republican debate. It's not the media making sexual assault this issue. Donald Trump is the one making sexual assault an issue.
They asked to come. They asked to come. But the reality is, can't we get off it? I mean, do we have to take the bait? I mean, why don't... The fact is, I was with Donald Trump all day yesterday. He mentioned the women for about 2 or 3 minutes, and then he talked about trade. In Maine, he talked about preserving their forest land. In New Hampshire, he talked, obviously, in New Hampshire, you're going to talk a lot about taxes, live free or die, state of New Hampshire. He talked about how he's going to reduce taxes to 33, 25, and 15%. She's going to raise taxes to 45%. If I become president, there'll be more money in your pocket. If she becomes president, she's going to take the money out of the pocket, and she's going to do an expanded Obamacare. He pointed out that in WikiLeaks, she's told us what we've always known, that she prefers socialized medicine. You know, I find WikiLeaks very refreshing. This is the Hillary Clinton I always knew existed. I just never had proof of it. People would say to me, she's a socialist. And I'd say, okay, but you can't prove it. Well, she was in Canada. She's talking to the Canadian bank or whatever. She says, I like your system, your socialized system of medicine, a lot better than ours. Mm-hmm. So, or I say something private that's different than something public. I've always known she was a liar and over and over again, a phony. So those things are things that are being concentrated on also, not just these women.
And we've been covering the WikiLeaks.
I know you have. I'm not criticizing you. I'm just explaining to you
when Donald Trump
gives a speech, he goes over what he wants to do with the he's in favor of the Second Amendment. She's against the Second Amendment. He goes through all that.
Sure. Big, long explanation. I understand that. Let me bring up something that Donald Trump is bringing up on the stump all the time. First of all, I mean, I think you would agree with the premise that our form of government has been strong because politicians accept the outcomes of elections, especially the most notable example in recent history with then Vice President Al Gore conceding after the very intense Florida recount. I want you to take a look at what a Trump supporter, Dan Bowman of Ohio, told the Boston Globe. Quote, if she's in office, I hope we can start a coup. She should be in prison or shot. He's a 50-year-old contractor. There's going to be a lot of bloodshed, but that's what it's going to take. I would do whatever I can for my country. There are a lot of Republican officials who are very concerned about Donald Trump constantly saying that the system is rigged, saying that if he loses a state such as Pennsylvania, it's only because it will be stolen. And now we have a Trump supporter calling for bloodshed. Are you not concerned at all about the tone and tenor of these remarks?
I've dealt with wacky jerks on my side and against me for too long to blame it on the candidate. You can find just as many wacko nuts on her side that write us horrible and awful things. So when he talks about a rigged election, he's not talking about the fact that it's going to be rigged at the polls. What he's talking about is that 80 to 85% of the media is against him. That when you look at the New York Times and you pick it up every morning, on the top of the paper, there are three stories that are anti-Trump. Some of them totally baseless, some of them silly. And then at the bottom, you get a little something about WikiLeaks. Same thing with the Washington Post. I mean, they're way out of control. The Daily News, clown outfits of
Donald
Trump.
Okay, but Mr. May, I understand that that's what
and you know that, please let me finish. You let Nancy Pelosi go on for like 2-3 minutes without interrupting her. Now, the reality is that he makes it clear. He points right at you at the press. He makes it clear who he thinks is rigging the
election. Then why does he call for people to go to elections, to go to polling places, to be election monitors? Why does he say, if I lose Pennsylvania, it will be because it's stolen? Pennsylvania state that hasn't gone Republican since 1988.
There are a few places, and not many in the swing states. There are a few places where they've been notorious for stealing votes. Pennsylvania, Chicago. There have been places where a lot of cheating has gone on over the years. I know that from my own knowledge of busing people in from Camden. When I ran for mayor of New York City the first time, some people voted 8 and 10 times. And the second time I had firefighters and police officers outside checking on the buses. So we take down the number of the bus had voted 10 times, and then we wouldn't let the bus vote again. So when I asked Randy Levine, who's now president of the Yankees, who did this for me, I said, how much of the cheating did we stop? He said, I think we stopped about 75% of it. We're still going to have to give him about 25,000 votes.
So
I'm sorry. Dead people generally vote for Democrats rather than Republicans.
So he's not talking about elections being stolen, except in some cases when he is talking about elections being stolen.
If you want me to tell me that I think the election of Philadelphia and Chicago is going to be fair, I would have to be a moron to say that. I mean, I would have to dislearn everything I learned in 40 years of being a prosecutor.
The Republican Party of Philadelphia would disagree with you. They looked into the allegations from 2012, and they said that there was nothing irregular with what happened there. Yes, there are areas where people only voted for Obama, just like in Utah, there are places that only voted for Romney.
Maybe there are situations in which it's right. I remember a case when I was Associate Attorney General where 720 dead people voted in Chicago in the 1982 election. I remember in my own election, about 60 dead people voted. So I can't sit here and tell you that they don't cheat. And I know because they control the polling places in these areas, there are no Republicans, that it's very hard to get people there who will challenge votes. So what they do is they leave dead people on the rolls, and then they pay people to vote those dead people. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
We have to go, Mr. Mayor, but just to put a button on this, it sounds as though you are saying that that Trump is serious when he says that the election is going to be stolen.
No, I'm not saying that.
You just laid out a whole case about how Democrats steal elections.
Look, if she wins Illinois by 8% or he wins Illinois by 8%, then that cheating isn't going to make any difference. If he wins Pennsylvania by 5 or she wins by 5, it'll make no difference. If it's a 1 or 2 point race, it could make a difference in a few places. Not going to make a difference in Indiana, not going to make a difference in North Carolina, not going to make a difference in a lot of other places.
Well, that's not
traditional cheating.
That's not an affirmation of the way our elections are held in this country.
We do cheat. We have people who cheat in elections. I mean,
Only Democrats cheat.
I've found very few situations where Republicans cheat. They don't control the inner cities the way Democrats do. Maybe if Republicans control the inner cities, they do as much cheating as Democrats.
I think there are a lot of elections experts that would have very, very strong disagreements with you.
Well, then they never prosecuted election fraud.
All right. Mr. Mayor, thank you so much. Appreciate it.